Okay, welcome to the next leg of my coast-to-coast tour. Leg 21, in fact, from Reno to Okemah. I'm going to say I was underway in a moment. So yeah, Okemah, our destination today. About 1,500 today in altitude. Okay, that's the parts out then. I think we're all good to depart out. Bit more cloud about today. So Oklahoma City is off to, well, pretty much dead ahead of us actually. You can't see it yet. And our destination airport at F-81. Look, we expect on arrival. Elevation is 876 feet. Team and 36 on the runways. I look at when a request on destination. Destination station, variable agent. So I'll land runway 18, which is from the south. Actually, I reported over there. This is the most cloud I've seen about in a while. These flights. So we're literally going to fly across Oklahoma. Take the heading, keep on our track a little bit better. So we hit Oklahoma City, which I'm just coming to the outskirts of now. It's dead ahead of us there, you can see it. Leveling off at 5,500 feet. So Okemah, what can we tell you about Okemah, our destination for this leg? Well, it's in Oklahoma. It's an interesting name, Okemah. Let's see the origin of it. Okemah, city in Oklahoma. It's the largest city in the county seat of Okefiskee County, and it's the birthplace of folk music legend Winnie Guthrie. And the Thlopthloco, terrible tribal town, a federally recognized Muscogee Indian tribe is headquartered there. Masked that pronunciation. So right here's Oklahoma City. Just passing over it now. And it's at the airport. I can see a way to my left here. Is that an airport? Yes, it does look like it. I know it's the main airport in Oklahoma. It doesn't necessarily look like it. But there it is, Oklahoma City. Surprisingly green, actually. There's another airport ahead of us, that looks like possibly the main airport. Yeah, I would say that's maybe it. It's, however, it's not our destination for today. Lake Thunderbird State Park is to the southeast of Oklahoma City and Shawnee, the next Mocha, I just found it. Curiously enough, there's a settlement town city before Okemah called Prague. Obviously not to the Prague of the Czech Republic, obviously. Bit of a bumpy ride up here today, not as smooth as some of my recent flying has been. Ease back on the throttles, we will increase the fuel, lean the mix, sorry. Still really following Interstate 40 for such a fair old few legs of this tour now. And we'll be landing runway 18, so we're the right side where we need to be, to the north of the line we're following. Industrial zone in like downtown Oklahoma there, where you can see the high rises. We were 16 nautical miles away. There we go. So we've still got a fair bit of flying to do yet, but we're well on route. City we're flying over, but a bit stuttery. Fly a bit that way. Not too much of the winds are going to blow me that way anyway. So we're heading in towards the eastern part of Oklahoma. And Okemah is actually named after a Kickapoo Indian chief. And March 1902, Chief Okemah built a bark house in his tribe's traditional fashion. Language Okemah actually means things up high, such as highly placed person, town, or high ground. Okay. Always interesting to learn about the history of a place. That's what I like about flight sim. You go somewhere and it's like, oh, read up about that, find out about it. You learn some interesting things. Decidedly greener as well, really leaving the aridness of Arizona far behind us. Of course, we're right in tornado country now. Tornado Alley, as they call it. As it says, cloud about, but still pretty nice weather. Nice and warm, even though we're heading towards the autumn months now. Still very warm here in Oklahoma. city of Oklahoma behind us now. If we see Lake Thunderbird, oh there it is. There's Lake Thunderbird State Park. You can see just off our wingtip there. Yeah, we're still in sort of almost the suburbs of Oklahoma City. Beyond, a little bit beyond that now, actually. So as I announced on my Facebook page recently, I've applied to join, applied for early access on the alpha test on FlightSim 2020, hoping that that will be successful. Good old ATC. Say anything until I want to talk about something. Allowed to talk about it, not allowed to upload anything. It's a non-disclosure agreement, so unless specifically instructed to or allowed to, then I won't be able to share anything of it. Pretty much all I'll be able to say is things like, I've had a flyabout on it and you're gonna love it. That's probably the limit of what I'd be able to tell you. If that. clear prime directly ahead of us. Yeah, see the clouds clearing away now to find weather. So we continue across to our destination. Spring rain showers will be landing soon. So Prague, we're passing off to our right here. See it just under the wing there. And, quite as grand as its more illustrious Czech namesake. Actually, this place isn't named Sacred Prague, it didn't really. Okay, we're going to get descending down shortly. We're going to descend down, descend down to 3,000 feet. It's back, but lights on. We go descend down to 3,000 feet. So just north of Okemah. Give me the name. Descending there nicely.
Turn right, heading 2 and 4-5, resume on navigation. Climb and maintain flight level 350, American Board
need to power back off.
See an NVIDIA ahead of me here. It's here somewhere. Oh, I see, can't see it. Where is it now? Oh, there. It's that strip there, I reckon. Must be. Is it just like a little grass strip or something? Jesus. We'll try and land it on that thing. That's gonna be fun. Big at all, does it? No, this is going to be a fun one to try and land. No pappies or anything. Don't really land this as slow as I can, as slow as I dare, and then storing it. it's about 10 feet long. Grass strip request, isn't it? There it is. If it was asphalt. Down. Yeah, that's a pretty reasonable landing, actually. Is this the scenery is wrong and the grass is too high or something? I don't know. Interesting. Anyway, we'll shut it down and follow the plan. It looks like the scenery is all wrong and there should be asphalt here. Let's see. Yes, submit. Okay. It's going to have a good replay, I think. So, quite a reasonable landing. Came in over the 500-foot high tree there. It's decent enough. It's like a little bit firm, maybe. Decent landing, we got that pretty much right in the middle as well. I'm really happy with that actually. Let's just take the replay back and nose perspective and finish there. There we go. So that just about brings us to the end of this, the 21st leg of my Coast to Coast tour. Over the halfway point, we have arrived here in Okemah in Oklahoma. Thank you once again for coming along with me on one of my flights. And of course, I wish you a pleasant onward browsing journey. And look forward to welcoming you back aboard another flight in the very near future. So, as we touch down here in a very sunny and warm Okemah, it's time once again to be annoyed by the stutteriness of chase planes replays and bid you all a farewell until next time. Goodbye for now.